Hi guys, welcome to today's class. Today we'll be doing a heart wall hanging. So I'm attaching the cords using the lark's head knot. The cords are 1 meter in length. We'll be attaching 12 cords. Space them equally and attach 12 cords. Now we leave the first 4 and the last 4 cords and start making the square knot. We make one square knot on the right side and one on the left side. Now follow the video and make square knot as I do. Take the rope below the square knot which we have done and make 2 more square knot below the first square knot which we have done on both the sides. So once you have done that, make a square knot in between the 2 square knots which you have done. So you will be forming a small flower like pattern on both the sides. Now we have to make the square knot on both the ends. Follow the video and make an entire row like how I have done. You should make the new square knots in line with the previous knots so that it forms a single row. See, now we are taking the center 2 cords and making the square knot which will be forming a straight row. So everything should be in the same level. So tighten the square knot in such a way that they all remain in a straight line. So now we have formed one straight line of square knots. So go to the center and make another square knot. For this row, we are leaving the first two and the last two cots and making square knot, similar to the alternating square knots. Now we make another row of square knots. So we include the first two and the last two cots. So it's the alternating square knot. So in this row, we will be leaving the first two and the last two cots and make the knots. The previous row we did for the entire row. Now we leave the first four and the last four cots and start making the square knots. So the next row we have to leave out the first six and the last six cots and make square knot. So we are making two square knots in this. The next row will be the last square knot, and the heart shape is almost formed. So we are done with it. I'll take it out and place it on a table and show you how we cut the fringes. So this is how it looks. If you like it, you can just leave it like that, or you can give some shapes by cutting the edges. So you can either cut it straight or an inverted V or the V shape, anything. I am going to cut it in the inverted V pattern and show you. So now we'll attach a cord for hanging it on the wall. So after finishing, remove the excess cord and you can seal it with the glue, or you can just insert it into the adjacent ropes and secure it like this. Now I have put it on the wall. This is how it looks. You can even accessorize it by adding some tassels, pom-poms, or anything you like. So this is for today's class. We'll see in the next class. Try out the project and let me know how it turns out for you. Thank you. Bye.